were determined to make amends for our debacle in Manchester. And fortunately for us, that day it was bright and sunny, and also the wicket was a good batting wicket. And Australia, I think, won the toss and elected to bat first. And those were 60-over games. The first ever World Cup was 60-over game. In the 60-over games, they posted 320 runs, I think, for the loss of 6 wickets or so. And in our turn, we got off to a fairly good start against that hostile pace attack. I think it was Ranjit Fernando and Sunil Vettamuni who opened the batting. They gave us a fair start of about 40-50 runs. And it was followed by Bandula Varnapura, who also got some runs. Dulip Mendis followed, and he too got into the act and was getting runs at a considerable pace when unfortunately he was struck by a bouncer from trying to hook a bouncer from Jeff Thompson right on the forehead, and he just couldn't bat thereafter. Fortunately, it wasn't a very bad injury, although the ball struck him very hard. He had to be carried off the field.
Then you walked in?
I had to walk in. After that, it took me some time to see that Dulip was all right after he returned to the dressing room, and it took me some time to get to the centre, and people would have been wondering whether I was coming in to bat or not after that. But managed to get in there and stick it out. And I must say that the first over I faced off Jeff Thompson, he had this slinging action which really didn't give the batsman much of a chance of picking the ball off his hand. And the first over I faced him, I only saw the ball whizzing past my head. Fortunately, nothing caught the head. I was able to survive that first over, and thereafter started getting used to the pace and the wicket, and managed to accumulate something like 46 runs and was associated with a fairly good partnership with Michael Tissera.